Ms. Littell can now breathe a sigh of relief, at least for now. That's after the Senate adopted a resolution that essentially greenlit the telco's rollout of its plans. But Senator Grace Poe clarifies, this doesn't mean that they're recognizing the Dennis Uy-led consortium as the new major player. Here's the report.
The Senate on Wednesday adopted the House concurrent resolution that transfers the ownership of Mindanao Islamic Telephone Company, or MISLATEL, to the consortium that's made up of Udena Corporation, Chelsea Logistics, and state-owned China Telecom. The group won the bidding for the country's third telco player that will take on incumbents Globe and PLDT. This means that Dennis Uy-led venture can now continue rolling out its plans to begin the massive undertaking of making a substantial impact in the challenging telco space. House Minority Leader Franklin Drilon, along with Risa Ontiveros and Ping Lacson, however, opposed the resolution. Drilon once again raised Ms. Littell's failure to operate within the prescribed time, as stated on the terms of its franchise.
Has it commenced operations, in fact, up to today?
It does not seem so, Mr. President. Non-operation was admitted during the committee hearing.
Yes,
Mr. President.
They could have operated somewhere else, because it's a nationwide franchise, and they did not do so.
That is correct, Mr. President.
The opposition senator again reminded his colleagues that these failures have invalidated Ms. Littell's franchise.
The franchise is deemed ipso facto revoked.
That is the wording of Section 7, Mr. President.
That's right. It could be the correct interpretation.
The position taken by Ms. Littell, Mr. President, is that the phrase ipso facto revoked would require one of two acts, Mr. President. Citing the decision of the Supreme Court in NTC versus PLDT versus NTC and Divina Gracia versus NTC, that either the state through the Solicitor General files a co-warrant proceeding to so cancel the franchise.
He also raised Ms. Littell's failure to seek Congress's approval when it sold the controlling stake to the group of Nicanor Escalante. Lacson also took into consideration the objections raised by Drilon in making his decision.
I could see the merit in the points raised by the good minority leader. I would like to disclose, no, and I feel sorry to do this, but I'm also casting a negative vote.
But Public Services Committee Chair Grace Poe, however, clarified that the upper chamber's adoption of the resolution does not mean that it's recognizing the consortium as the third telco. She explained that she sponsored the measure to end the public's desperation for better telco services. Poe also said that interested parties can always go to the courts if they want to challenge Ms. Littell's legitimacy. This also does not mean that they're automatically renewing the firm's franchise that's set to expire in 2023. Ms. Littell is embarking on a gargantuan task to disrupt the telco industry. It's promising to offer internet with speeds of around 27 megabytes per second in its first year. It will then bring this up to 55 Mbps in the next 4 years. The consortium is also aiming to provide 37% coverage in its maiden year. It's looking to cover at least half of the country in the next year of operation before raising it to 70% in the following year. To do all this, it's going to spend 150 billion pesos on the first year of its operations alone. It's also earmarking 27 billion pesos in capex over the next 4 years.